Hi there, and welcome to a short overview of the structure of ATP, which is also known as adenosine triphosphate. Now, ATP has similarities with RNA in the sense that it uses a nitrogenous base, and the one that you see is adenine. Which DNA also has two, but the big similarity that links it a little bit more to RNA is the presence of the ribose sugar that you also see in RNA. And then keep in mind with nucleic acids, they also have a phosphate group. What makes ATP special, what energetically that it's used for energy in the cell, is that it has three phosphate groups. It's the T, it's that triphosphate. So we have the basic adenine structure here, the ribose structure here. These two collectively are called adenosine. That's where that part comes from. And now we're going to diagram the triphosphates. And depending on the double bonds and charges might be slightly different in different figures in terms of the oxygens and the charges and whether it's single or double bonded. So phosphate is your phosphorus group bonded with four oxygens around it. And where the real magic is in this wavy line here between the phosphate groups. We'll keep that like that. Actually, let's do this. Okay, and there's your phosphorus with your with your oxygens that are attached. And then you have that last one that's out here. Those are your phosphate groups. So keep in mind, in a nucleic acid, it's just going to be these first three pieces, the adenine, ribose, and phosphate. I just mentioned that because there is, it's a familiar structure. There's some similarities there. So energetically, where all the magic really happens, again, is out in these bonds. And this first one, hence these wavy bonds I've highlighted here, this first one is the kind of biggest bang for your buck. This is the ATP part. However, the cell can also further break those bonds down. So it can break it down to ADP, or adenosine diphosphate. And then in some cases, you even see AMP, where you get down to just having the one. Depends on how much you need the energy, I guess. But you don't get quite as much as you move down the bond. So everywhere where you've got these bonds here, you can get a little bit of energy that are out of these. There's also some other nucleic acid type derivatives like this that are used for energy. So GTP, which is another nitrogenous base, your guanine triphosphate. You can have CTP for cytosine, TTP for thymine, UTP. So you do see those in other pathways. It's just that ATP is the primary currency of energy. So to get these phosphates put back on once they've been utilized for energy is a very long and energetically intensive process. So typically we're looking at ADP having the last phosphate put back on, but that's a multi-step process. So you'll cover some pathways to do that in things like aerobic respiration. Okay, and that is the structure of ATP. And this is Corey Andres with Central New Mexico Community College using CNM.